Hi guys, today we're at the Spark Museum of Electrical Invention in Bellingham, Washington. Let's go check it out.
The Spark Museum of Electrical Invention in Bellingham, Washington is a fun and interactive science museum which highlights the history, science, and power of electricity. The museum contains one of the most complete collections of its kind, with unique and rare artifacts dating back to the early days of electrical experimentation in the 1600s through to the golden age of radio and television in the 1950s. It also houses the largest collection of 19th century electromagnetic apparatus found in any private collection, as well as rare music boxes, early phonographs, and many examples of radio broadcast technology. Kids can get hands-on in the electricity lab to learn the fundamentals of electrical science, generating charges using static electricity or simple machines, and experimenting with the effects of the Van de Graaff generator. But adults will enjoy uncovering the many gems hidden within this museum's massive collection. The dawn of the electrical age ran between 1600 and 1800 as scientists began to learn more about static electricity, with early electrostatic generators allowing scientists to create and control electric charges. Their curiosity inspired experiments like the famous kite experiment performed by Benjamin Franklin in 1752, and led to inventions like Leyden jars, an early type of capacitor which allowed electrical charges to be stored, the Volta cannon, which used sparks to ignite swamp gas, and the first electrical batteries, known as voltaic piles, which could provide continuous electric current to a circuit. These early advances helped usher in the Age of Invention in the early 1800s, known as the Second Industrial Revolution. During this time, scientists continued to learn how to harness the power of electricity. Leading to breakthrough inventions like the Edison electric lamp. And this particular one on display at the museum is one of the very first that was used to demonstrate working light bulbs. Although Edison often gets the credit, there were many inventors working on similar ideas at the time, or on alternatives like these Geissler tubes, which are a precursor to modern neon lights. There were also significant advances in communications, first with the invention of electric telegraphs, and then quickly followed by the invention of the telephone. This is an example of one of the first dial telephones, but an even cooler item is this Higginson telephone, which was used in a conversation with Alexander Graham Bell's assistant Thomas Watson to open up the first transcontinental telephone line in 1915. Inventors continued to search for other practical uses of electricity, like Edison's electric pen, this phrenology helmet, which claimed to cure a variety of illnesses using jolt therapy, or this shoe-fitting fluoroscope, which helped customers select the proper footwear using X-rays. Competing advances in electrical technology also caused the War of the Currents between inventors Thomas Edison and Nikola Tesla, who battled over which method of electrical distribution was the most efficient, Edison's direct current or Tesla's alternating current. In the late 1800s and early 1900s, things began to go wireless with Marconi's invention of the wireless transmitter. Marconi achieved fame in 1901 when he built a spark transmitter powerful enough to send radio waves across the Atlantic Ocean. The Spark Museum also has a reproduction of the radio room on the Titanic, which is outfitted with a rare original Marconi wireless set. Operators would have signaled from here using Morse code, calling out for assistance as the ship sank into the waters of the North Atlantic. You can try your hand at Morse code from this reconstruction of a wireless telegraph shore station, similar to those operating in Northwest Washington around 1912. And be sure to check out the only surviving Collins wireless telephone, An early version of this technology, which was showcased at the Canadian National Exhibition in 1909. This time also saw many changes in home entertainment, with the widespread popularity of recorded music. In the early years, this took the form of phonographs, like the ones made by Edison, which recorded audio on wax cylinders, but eventually gave way to disc recordings, which were cheaper to produce, easier to transport, and more durable. This type of media continued to evolve over the years, eventually taking the form of vinyl records, and although these are traditionally black, early 45 RPM records produced by RCA Victor were color-coded to categorize different genres of music. The 1920s also gave rise to the golden age of radio. For the first time, families could gather round and listen to live music, news broadcasts, or classic radio shows like Jack Benny and The Shadow. Soon, the invention of television added visuals. Although early televisions were often bulky pieces of furniture with tiny screens limited to blurry black and white images. Of course, this is just the briefest recap on the history of electricity, and the Spark Museum is filled with thousands of artifacts that each have their own story to tell. But that's not all the museum has to offer. On weekends, you can also witness the MegaZapper electrical show, where guests are presented with live demonstrations of various electrical devices, including one of the largest Tesla coils in the country, standing 9 feet tall. Brave guests can take on the Cage of Doom, standing within inches of 4.6 million volts of loose electrical energy. There's a ton to learn about here, and I'd highly recommend visiting this museum and taking a deep dive into the fascinating history of electrical science. Because it's not just educational, it's also a lot of fun.
And thanks for joining me at the Spark Museum. Hope you enjoyed the tour. Until next time, remember to keep exploring.